So, this is kind of sad, if what I'm about to say is true. For those of you that don't know, the developers over at Insurgency Sandstorm, New World Interactive, have decided to do a documentary with The Escapist on some insight into their development and how their games have been doing thus far. When I heard about this, I thought, this is a really cool idea, because I always find it fascinating to see what goes on behind the scenes and what goes into development. The Escapist had a trailer that came out fairly recently, so I thought that I would take a gander. And I gotta say, it was a pretty neat little trailer that they had. It looked like it was really high quality. I'll leave a link in the description if you guys want to go check it out. But there was one thing that kind of stuck out to me. It was this line here.
We wanted to create an all-out story mode. We wanted to do cooperative multiplayer. We wanted to do competitive multiplayer. And you see where I'm going with this, right? It was just too much.
This little line right here is what got me to do this video, because he's right. Generally, when you decide to do a sequel to the first game, you want to go bigger and better. That's how these things normally go, and that's how it sounded like the marketing for Sandstorm was going to be, or at least when I first heard about the marketing of the game. But as we all know, that didn't happen. If anything, Sandstorm at launch was more of a step back from the original, with less features, game modes, no story mode, and seemingly to be towards a casual audience. This is why a lot of people seem to compare Insurgency Sandstorm to Call of Duty a lot. Even I did at one point when I heard about the TDM that was getting added. But yeah, this kind of got me thinking about how successful the original Insurgency was, because New World Interactive just hasn't been able to replicate that success. I mean, if we look at Steam charts, and just to be clear, this is not indicative of their sales. We don't actually know how many people have bought the game. We are only looking at how many people have played it, so I just want to be clear about that. But look at how many people have actually played it at some point in time. Now, if we compare that to Day of Infamy, the second game that they had ever made, or third, but I don't know if I want to count the first one because that one was a mod. Okay, the second one that they had ever made but got money off of. Ugh. Compared to the original Insurgency, this would almost seem like a flop. It did not do very well. And after a while, they started to bundle Day of Infamy with the original Insurgency just to get people playing it. So that's already not a good sign. And then fast forward to Insurgency Sandstorm's launch, and it sold less than Day of Infamy. Or it had a less player count than Day of Infamy. Again, I don't have the sales on hand. But who knows? Maybe it sold better, maybe it didn't, I don't know. I'm just going based off of how many people have actually gotten into the game at some point in time. And it's less than Day of Infamy. Like, to me, this feels like Insurgency Sandstorm was a Hail Mary pass. Like, they wanted to go all in on it, but they couldn't do all the things that they wanted to do because they didn't have a lot of funding. At least that's what I'm taking away from this. And because they didn't have the funding, they weren't able to add the ambitious things that they wanted to add into Sandstorm. So Sandstorm felt more like a safe bet rather than an ambitious one, with the interesting choices of adding in a TDM mode and a zombie mode. This is why some people like to compare it to games like Call of Duty, because it's straight away from the tactical genre that it used to be within the original. When they didn't add that single player story mode, which is what I was the most interested in, or the game modes that the majority of fans wanted, I think that was a really big blow to their player base. Maybe you have a different assumption, you know, tell me down in the comments below. So I think that New World Interactive is really struggling with trying to get their games off the shelf because of straying away from their original formula, like what made Insurgency Insurgency. Like, I've talked to a lot of people that played Sandstorm, and they always tell me that they launched too early, like there's not enough there. And I mean, they're not wrong. Like, the first thing that they should have done was quite literally remake the original game and then build it off of that. I've also heard people say that switching over to the Unreal Engine was probably an even bigger issue for them, which, I mean, I don't disagree, but there was a time when they didn't have any content coming out for like the past 5 months, and the only thing that really released was like 5 guns and just a few updates, very few, which I believe was because they were working on the engine or trying to fix a bunch of bugs that they were having trouble with, because that transition from the easy to use Source engine to the much harder to use Unreal engine is just a big step for this studio. So obviously it would take them more time. And that really dropped the player count, which I did cover at one point. It went down to like 800, but then the developers dropped a big update. And because a lot of players perceive the developers as good developers, a lot of people gave them another chance, and the player base came back and shot back up again. It was sitting at around 2,000 to 3,000 after the update. I mean, goodwill can only get you so far, because recently, one of my subscribers had actually sent me a picture of Steam charts, and this was about 6 days ago, showing the player base dropping down to around 80 players. Like, oh my god, what a drop off! It dropped down that much? Jesus Christ. If I was one of the developers working on Insurgency Sandstorm, I would be like, uh-oh, wake-up call, ding, 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 everybody get to their stations, we gotta make sure the ship is still afloat. But then fairly recently, they dropped an update saying that they would have game modes coming out almost every week. Guess that was the wake-up call. Within the game modes that are already there. So, I mean, I guess that's good, but they seriously need to get on the ball, because with the amount of people that are comparing Insurgency Sandstorm to Call of Duty, and we see a new Call of Duty that actually looks very tactical on the way, that game could quite literally kill Insurgency Sandstorm if they don't get back to their roots. Like, what they have in the game is good, but they need to add everything that was in the previous game into that game. Like, they need mods. They need all the modes that previous fans want to be into the game. And looking at their Twitter feed, it seems like they're actually doing that, but they need to do it faster. Hashtag, where's the sense of urgency for Insurgency? Because Call of Duty is right around the corner. In order for them to retain their base, they have to go back to what made Insurgency Insurgency. Because if they don't, and people keep comparing Insurgency to Call of Duty, Insurgency is screwed. I mean, I really like the developers and I do want their game to succeed, but the future isn't looking too bright if they keep going on this casual path. I mean, again, the updates from their Twitter doesn't seem like they're actually doing that. It looks like they're actually going back to their roots, but they gotta do it faster. So those are my thoughts on Insurgency Sandstorm, because that big drop down to 80 players really got me thinking about that, along with what they said in the documentary trailer. So what are your guys' thoughts? I haven't actually slept yet. It is literally 6 in the morning and I haven't slept, so maybe I'm going crazy. I don't know. Am I correct in what I'm saying? I mean, at this point of the video, I'm just like confused. Like when I got to like 1 o'clock, I forgot what I was talking about. I was reading off of the script, but then the script ran out and I was just like rambling at this point. So am I right or am I just tired as fuck? If you liked the video, be sure to subscribe, ding the bell, share the video, like the video. If you want to support me, check out my Patreon or the NordVPN link down below. And with that, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.